we're going to do two logos in less than 10 minutes. One that's simplistic and just with words, but stunning. Another one with art, also on Canva. Let's jump in and do that. Welcome, content creators and entrepreneurs. My name is Zanele. We're meeting for the very first time, and you've joined me at African Multi Design, a channel dedicated to help you grow online and give you super ideas on how to do content creation and marketing online. So we're going to help our buddy Han. This is his channel on YouTube. He would like to find out which logo should he go with. So we're going to give him two options. Han, the guys are with you. They're going to help you decide. We're going to jump in and show you how to do it. And then you must, you know, let us know which one you go with. Instagram post for our design. And we're going to search for text so that we can add. We're going to start with this first one, the one with just the words. So we're going to add our text. And we... So we're going to look for a nice font that Han can use on his design. I like this one. And we're just going to make that a little bit bigger. And we're going to add a secondary text to explain what he does on his channel. He shows people how to do art. Okay, we're also going to change that text and make it a nice pro version kind of a text. Let's make that a little bit big. Happy with that. We should just make that a little bit bigger. Nicely done. So both the text, I'm going to change the color to silver, and then we're gonna download it as a transparent background. If you don't have a pro version, you can use removebg.com. And then you can just go ahead and download it as a plain version. Now we're going to jump into Photopea, and we're going to look for our 3D mockup. You know, you can download mockups on freepik.com as well. I just find this particular one that I've been using easier, but there's thousands and thousands of mockups that you can download and use. Some of them you buy, some of them for free. You double click on the logo, you hide the words, and then you place Han's logo. We go find it on our downloads. There we go, and we add it there. We grab it and we put it in the middle of the page. And then we're going to save as a smart object. We wait for the lines to disappear while it's converting to smart object. And then we're going to then convert it into a 3D mockup. So it's saved as a smart object. You just click on the 3D glass window logo. And there we go. There you go, Han. There's your first option. Now we're going to close this one, and we're going to jump back on Canva, and we're going to do the second one. So second one, I'm also going to use an Instagram post, but this time I'm going to go to elements and I'm going to search for H as I'm looking for Han hobbies. And I'm going to scroll down until I find a nice looking H like this one. This one I like, that one is also nice. That one with flowers is also nice. But I fell in love with this age, and then I'm just gonna make it big and change color to red, and then add text as a subheading text. Make that big and then write what the channel does. We're gonna change the color for that one as well, and then we're gonna go back to elements, and then we're gonna look for lines. This time we'll take that nice line, we change the color to red, move it so that it's just below the logo. Let's just increase the weight a little bit so that it's a little bit nice and prominent, and we're done. Download and we save as transparent, and same as the last one we did, we go to Photopea, we place it over there, and we go to our downloads and we look for the logo that we've just done for our homemade art. You drag, you make it big, put it in the middle, and then you change it to smart object. And it converts. There we go. Then we click on the 3D glass window logo. And if you enjoy our tutorial, please don't forget to subscribe. And there we go. There's option number 2. Han, you would then export to the kind and the size that you want. You guys need to let Han know which one he should go with between the two. So sometimes you just need simplicity. Sometimes you need beautiful art like this one. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. I'll see you on the next one. Don't forget to subscribe.